Hi, my nail fairies. Welcome back to another dip powder tutorial. Today, we are going to encapsulate gold medal slices with dip powder. Colors I'll be using are pink lipstick D422 and light pink D402LS from Kira Sky. Please excuse my voice, my allergies are acting up. As usual, I'll be using my pH prep to prevent lifting and my vitamin dip base. Now we're going to do a second coat of each color before I add on the metal slices. Now I'm going to stick the gold medal slices onto the accent nail with base bond and then dip it into the clear powder. I am going to dip it into the clear powder probably about 3 times. The only thing I did not like about that was that it was a little thick and I didn't like it to be that thick on a nail. I had a lot of filing to do at the end. I decided to do this because I've seen this done with acrylic and monomer. So I said, hey, let me try it out with the dip powder to see how it turns out. Usually with the dip powder and, I'm sorry, with the acrylic and the monomer, I would probably just have to do an overlay like maybe 2 times and that would be it. But because the dip powder, which is acrylic, but we're not activating it with monomer, we're activating it with the dip base. You have to do it more times in order for it to cover what it is you're trying to encapsulate. Because if you don't, when you start filing, it will basically eat at the little metal piece and your design will be ruined. Solidify to dry the layers of dip powder, and then I'm gonna file. I do want to apologize in advance because again I could not fast forward the filing part of it, but I think that I figured out what's going on with my videos and it'll be fixed in the next video, crossing my fingers. So hopefully I'll fix it. So I am sorry about the extensive filing and that I couldn't fast forward it. That accent nail was so thick, I couldn't stop filing. I became so obsessed with that nail. I don't think I'm gonna ever do this again with dip powder. If I ever encapsulate again, it would probably be with regular acrylic and monomer. But this drove me absolutely insane. I got it as thin as possible, and then I don't even think I wore these nails for like 2 days. I think I took them off like 3 days after, because it annoyed the heck out of me because the nail was so thick. Koopa gel top coat to seal it all in. Thank you for watching, my nail fairies. I hope you enjoyed this video. Until next time, kisses!